Hello students, welcome to the lecture on hotel design, and after this lecture we will be able to learn the following objectives: understand the hotel and resort development and biodiversity, explain the biodiversity principles for sitting and design of hotels and resorts, define the systematic layout planning or SLP, explain the interior decoration or design. Let's start with the concept of hotel design. Hospitality design has come a long way since the 1980s construction wave. Hotel investors today are more cautious, with less time and money to spend on design and construction, and more interested in the bottom line. Significant changes have occurred in the way the design product is delivered to the client. The developers are conscious of the needs of the guests, and while maintaining functionality and economic viability, they want to anticipate and comply with the needs of the guests. Guests demand for a more personalized hotel experience is rewriting the rules for architecture, space allocation and interior design. Hoteliers provide this experience by making hotel space look, work and feel more like home. This can be carried out by ensuring that the rooms are more functional, aesthetically elegant, comfortable and saving over the top luxury for the guest bathroom. The trend is also to cut back on multiple restaurants and use the space to add a spa. Baby boomers view spas as a special amenity. Downsizing and personalizing the public space is another step taken by the hoteliers in creating the residential ambience. Pared down public spaces mean more emphasis on initial accessibility. Hotels are choosing to use more local materials to enable them to fit better with the environment. Local materials can be very effective and cost lesser than the other alternatives. Future hotel design innovation will be driven by customer needs and requirements and future technology. In combination with the current design trends, the future trends will encompass environmental concerns, cultural authenticity, and the thirst for adventure. The five experimental technologies that have the potential to revolutionize the future of hotel design are smart building materials, including glass that is light sensitive, super strength steel, wood and concrete to withstand earthquakes and hurricanes, superstructural system, including domes that can span entire cities, skyscrapers and underwater foundation for building above water, environmental and energy advances, including inexpensive fuel sources and walls to keep interiors at a constant temperature, hyper design tools including 3D virtual reality images for viewing buildings before they are constructed, and interactive brainwave visual analyzers, including products that allow human brainwaves to control electronic devices such as lights, computers, heating, cooling and entertainment option. Thank you. Now we will discuss the hotel and resort development and biodiversity. Integrating biodiversity consideration into sitting and design decision for hotel and resort development is important not only for the continued viability and conservation of the ecosystem, but also for the long-term financial success of the hotels and resorts. The tourism industry, including the hospitality sector, depends strongly on healthy ecosystem, because those ecosystem and the wildlife habitats, landscapes and natural attractions that comprise them are often the very thing that draws tourists to the destination in the first place. The biodiversity footprint of hotels and resorts. Despite their dependence on an interconnectedness with biodiversity, hotels and resorts can have significant negative impacts on ecosystem and natural resources. A hotel impacts biodiversity at each stage of its life cycle, from planning through to closure. At the planning stage, the most important issue in determining the level of impact that a hotel will have relates to choices about its sitting and design. Choices about the materials that will be used to construct the hotel, where those materials will come from, and the total physical footprint of the hotel will also influence how significant its impact will be in the operational stage. At the construction stage, impact is determined by the size and location of the area cleared for development and where construction activities are taking place, the choice of construction methods, the sources and amount and type of materials, water and energy used to build the hotel, the location of temporary camps for construction workers, inadequate storage facilities for construction materials, the amount of construction waste that has to be disposed of, and other types of damage such as surface soil erosion or compaction caused by construction activities or disruption of natural water flows and drainage patterns. Biodiversity impacts associated with the sitting, design and construction of hotels. Impacts of land clearing and landscape modification. Changes in local land use and cover are one of the main drivers affecting biodiversity and ability of ecosystem to provide ecosystem goods and services. Does the land clearing and landscape modifications occurring during the construction phase can potentially have significant impacts on biodiversity unless properly managed. Removal of vegetation to make way for accommodations and access roads can lead to flooding, increased erosion, landslides, loss of soil fertility, lowering of the water table and siltation of rivers, lakes and other water bodies. Loss of critical habitats as a result of land clearing can severely impact plant and animal species, some of which may be endemic to the area that is found nowhere else on Earth. In relatively undeveloped areas, opening up access to a development site with roads or other rights of way can catalyze further damage by facilitating migration to previously inaccessible areas. Now moving on to the next topic, we will study the biodiversity principles for sitting and design of hotels and resorts. The biodiversity principles for sitting and design of hotels and resorts focus on how biodiversity and associated social impacts can be better addressed in hotel and resort development. The principles seek to provide guidance in the planning and construction stages of the hotel life cycle. They are targeted at all relevant stakeholders, including planning authorities, tourism development agencies, developers, investors, hotel managers and management companies, project managers and consultants, architects and construction firms. It is also expected that these principles will be integrated into relevant policies and planning processes, including environmental impact assessment, EIA procedures, national biodiversity strategies and action plans, NBSAP, national and local management plans, tourism development plans, and the environment management strategies of hotel corporations and developers. The study generated evidence of biodiversity impacts resulting from the sitting and design of hotels and identified examples of positive relationships. The five principles, the IUCN biodiversity principles for sitting and design of hotels and resorts, are as follows. adopt an ecosystem-based approach in tourism development planning, manage impacts on biodiversity from hotel development, and attempt to achieve an overall positive contribution, design with nature and adopt nature-based solutions, respect, involve, and support local communities, build collaboration among stakeholders, adopt an ecosystem-based approach in tourism development planning. Hotel and resort plannings and governmental agencies consider the dynamics of ecosystems, their services and interconnectivity when developing new hotels and resorts, and take into account the impacts that the developments could have on all components of the ecosystem concerned. Tourism planning adopts ecosystem-based approaches in order to maintain the integrity and essential values and services of ecosystem. An ecosystem-based approach helps identify and address cumulative and multi-source impacts of hotels and resorts. An ecosystem-based approach also calls for intersectoral cooperation between tourism, finance, land use planning, academic institution, and natural resource management departments and agencies in decision-making. Planning authorities employ adequate measures to monitor hotel construction practices and adherence to conditions of the development permit process. In addition, hotel construction is likely to generate or encourage other activities with potential impacts on biodiversity, such as a temporary resettlement of workers at the vicinity of an isolated site, or the transportation of construction materials, as well as a potential increase in visitations in areas surrounding the new hotel development during its operation. The EIA process takes these potential impacts into account, and it is the shared responsibility of developers and planners to monitor and manage them. Manage impacts on biodiversity from hotel development and adapt to achieve an overall positive contribution. Hotel and resort developers make all efforts to avoid negative impacts on biodiversity and associated livelihoods from sitting, design and construction. When impacts are unavoidable, efforts are made to avoid the areas of greatest biodiversity value, minimize the extent of development impacts, restore affected ecosystems and biodiversity to the greatest extent possible, and invest in additional conservation actions within the vicinity of the development. Hotel and resort developers should aim to achieve a demonstrable overall positive contribution to the conservation of local biodiversity. Developers and relevant government agencies should employ a clear sequencing of mitigation actions at the earliest planning stages to manage biodiversity risks from hotel and resort developments. Design with nature and adopt nature-based solutions. Where possible, hotels and resorts blend into their natural landscape, enhance it, and use nature as a source of inspiration in design and in operation. Hotel and resort developments aim to blend into the landscape and become integrated into the ecosystem. Building design, height, orientation, and density is guided by the natural settings and local architectural style. In order to reduce visual impact and intrusions while maximizing natural solution and optimizing cultural integration and identity, especially at more sensitive sites, the use of non-threatened species and natural, sustainable sourced and harvested materials is maximized in construction, and consideration is given to durability and the recyclable nature of all materials used in construction and furnishings. Respect, involve, and support local communities. Hotel and resort developments contribute positively to local community development, respect land rights and land use rights of local stakeholders and involve them in decision making. There are many examples of local communities being marginalized from their traditional uses, occupations and enjoyment of land and resources as a result of hotel and resort development. Beginning at the earliest planning stages and continuing through all phases of the development, developer assess social impacts on neighboring communities. This is not only a matter of good corporate citizenship, but also vital to ensure a social license to operate. The principle of free, prior and informed consent, EPIC, recognizes a community's inherent and prior right to the land and resources and respect its legitimate authority, requiring that any third party enter into an equal and respectful relationship with the community. Therefore, communities are informed about and consulted on any proposed hotel or resort, provided with information on its likely impacts and involved in meaningful participatory planning processes from the earliest planning stages and during the development process. Build collaboration among stakeholders. Reconciling hotel and resort development and biodiversity conservation can only be achieved with the participation of all parties concerned. Tourism development practitioners and national government authorities develop mechanism and hoc and long-term to support collaborative efforts that mobilize and foster the knowledge and capacities of all stakeholders. Let us now know the meaning of systematic layout planning, or SLP. The following definitions are based upon the systematic layout planning method, or SLP, by Muter. A relationship chart is the quantitative matrix containing the level of interaction between pairs of departments. The more positive the element in the matrix, the stronger two departments interact, and in general, the closer to each other they should be located. The more negative the relationship, the stronger two departments are incompatible with each other, and in general, the further apart they should be located. A relationship diagram is a spatial arrangement of the departments to represent the relationship data in a graphical way. Model and algorithm classification and hierarchy. The theoretical layout models and their solution algorithms can be classified and organized based upon the properties. Graph-based models generate an adjacency graph, while area-based models generate a conceptual block layout. Primal models maintain a feasible solution while attempting to obtain an optimal solution. Dual models maintain an optimal solution while attempting to obtain a feasible solution. In discrete area models, the departments and building are composed of a number of equal-sized unit squares. The block layout graph and the adjacency graph are related. In fact, they are dual graphs. The relationship diagram can be constructed from the block layout by placing a node inside each department and by drawing the connecting relationship edge if and only if the two departments are adjacent, that is, have a common wall. The resulting adjacency graph is planar. A graph is planar if it can be drawn in a two-dimensional plan without crossing edges. Procedure for plant layout planting. The data were collected and the number of tools or equipments for manufacturing was counted in terms of the direction for raw materials and product. The operation process chart, flow of material and activity relationship chart have been used in analysis. The problem of the plan was determined and analyzed through SLP method to plan the relationship between the equipment and the area. Interior decoration or design is the act of decorating a room so that it is attractive, easy to use and function well with existing architecture. The role of interior decorator probably came into existence in the 1720s in Western Europe, mostly being performed by men of diverse backgrounds. William Kent was trained as the first person to take charge of an entire interior, including internal architecture, furniture, selection and the handling of paintings in his own time and among the elites. In this industry, role was frequently filled by the upholsterer, sometimes called the upholder, while in Paris, the marge and marcier, a merchant of goods who act as general contractor, often filled this role. Application of design, principles to interior decoration. Interior decoration is an act of beautifying rooms and other indoor areas of a house so that they become attractive, comfortable and useful. Floors, walls and ceiling are often decorated using furniture and fixtures, carpets and rugs, draperies or curtains, lightings, paints, wall coverings, as well as many other items that may constitute the creation of an interior that is beautiful. The interior of a house often tells the story of what type of people live there. When we look at the colors, crafts and fine arts, arrangement for beauty and efficiency, it is at once reveals the individual's personalities of the members as a collective character of the family as a whole. There are no denying facts that our grandparents lived in dulled and drab houses for once of suitable color in those days. Houses should be a place for comfort, peace and relaxing the mind. So we must have the plane of color in room to produce a positive effect on our minds. The interior decoration. This is the intended arrangement of materials to produce a desired result and effect. The principle of design can be seen most clearly in visual arts of drawing, painting and architecture. Painting wall with lines, shapes and colors. They are also concerned with division of lines, the use of shapes and the shading of the colors. They try to arrange all these elements into a pattern that will seem emotionally satisfying to the speculator. If this effort is obtained, the design will have unity, harmony. A checklist for function space management. All the challenges unique to large convention hotels view are as complex as function space management. With bookings up to a decade into the future and the fine balance of partnering with convention centers while simultaneously booking groups contained entirely in-house, there are rarely clear indications of which business to take versus which to let go. Rather than throw our hands up in the air and just let business fall where it may, it is revenue management's responsibility to establish clearly defined parameters to direct future success for the sales team even without the benefit of a crystal ball. No group lead is going to fit perfectly into these guidelines, but they provide a measure by which different group opportunities can be evaluated. Following are a list of consideration that should be established upfront to streamline the process of function space management. Pick acceptable blocks for room-only groups. This does not actually access function space, but unless there is an extraordinary amount of local catering demand for the property, this needs to be established to ensure the space does not go dark and fail to generate revenue during city-wide conventions. Generally, this guideline is established by demand season based on the amount of group demand anticipated and the odds of finding a spacey group to fill up those empty function rooms. Group catering revenue per room night. For groups requiring function space, this is a better consideration than the traditional guideline of rooms to space ratio. A room to space ratio advises how much function space a group should receive based on how many rooms nights are provided. That is great, but a group taking a lot of guest rooms is automatically rewarded with a lot of function space, which is only warranted if they are actually paying for that space. We prefer to allocate space based on how much catering revenue, including room rental, is being collected per room night book. In my opinion, a small group with a lot of catering revenue can take as much or more space than a large group paying very little for the function space. As long as they pay for the space, it is none of my business how many people they put in it. Now in the end, let us summarize what we have learned in this lecture. Guest demand for a more personalized hotel experience is rewriting the rules for architecture, space allocation and interior design. Hotels are choosing to use more local materials to enable them to fit better with the environment. Integrating biodiversity considerations into setting and design decision for hotel and resort development is important, not only for the continued viability and conservation of the ecosystem. In coastal areas, the removal of dunes, wetlands and other natural habitats to provide land for development or to allow for better views or better access to beaches can threaten nesting, breeding and feeding grounds of birds, fish and mammals. An ecosystem-based approach helps identify and address cumulative and multi-source impacts of hotels and resorts.